one female and then ditch that bit. So I'm going to do it as 6x, 2x plus 1, so then minus a half of the x. So u is 2x plus 1, u dx is 2, and u over 2 is dx. So it becomes 6x, u to the minus a half, and u over 2. Then I'm going to think, oh, I need to get rid of that x. I've actually got 2x there, so I could actually be a bit sneaky here. I could see that as being 2x times by 3. So I can actually replace it because I've got u minus 1 is 2x. Or I could do u minus 1 over 2 and just replace the x. It's entirely up to you. So if I do it as 3 lots of u minus 1 times by u to the minus a half, du over 2. So I'll just replace that 6x, part of it is 3 times 2x. Tidy it up, expand my bracket. I've got a 3 divided by 2, and I've got a u to the 1 times u to the minus a half. Then I've got 3, well, I've got 3 times minus 1 times a half times u to the minus a half. Expand my bracket. Then I integrate it, I get 3 over 2 times by u to the 3 over 2 divided by 3 over 2, which is the same as times by 2 thirds, minus 3 over 2 u to the half divided by a half, which is times by 2, plus c. Tidy it up, the 3s and the 2s cancels there, I change the u back to 2x plus 1. The 2's cancelled, plus 6, okay. Follow up, number 1. Wow, this one's not easy at all. Alright, so let's have a think about this one then. I'm going to leave this square, down the bottom now, so it's going to get messy. Right, so. So dx by du, sine goes to cos, it's 3 cos u. So dx is 3 cos u du. Can this ever change? I've never seen one of these on a paper before, to be honest. I'm going to replace the u. Sine u. And replace near the dx, can't talk, with 3 cos u du. The 3 sine u all squared so I get 9 minus 9 sine squared u times by 3 cos u du. Now the 9 minus 9 sine squared, I can actually see as, are you ready for this? 9 lots of 1 minus sine squared, times by 3 cos u, du. The 1 minus sine squared is cos squared, so I've got 1 over 9 square root, oh no, hang on, 9 is inside the square root. Here we are. 1 over the square root of 9 cos squared. This will probably be the end. Like I said, I've not seen one like it. So then, if you look, the root 9 is a 3, the root cos squared is a cos, so it actually becomes 1 over 3 cos u times by 3 cos u du. So the 3's cancelled, the cos u's cancelled. I'm left with the integral of 1 du. So I get u plus c. And u is, well, what's u? U is the inverse sine of x over 3. So I take the 3 down and inverse sine it. So I've got the inverse sine or arc sine of x over 3 plus c. There's no real easy way of getting around it, but sorry everyone. This is one of those ones which is in the formula. It was in the book for ages, for years. It's not a formula book, but in the textbooks, but it's never ever done. So I've got one here, I'm using cos. Same idea. Oh, no, this one uses tan. Look at this bad boy. My word. Now I go and see if you're all right with it. It's nothing, you know, as hard. Let's go look for that one. Then we have some consolidation, so we finish that lesson. So that's the fourth lesson in the third lesson time.